You are at increased risk for heart attack or stroke if you have high cholesterol levels, high blood pressure, or if you smoke. The presence of any single risk factor doubles your risk. Having two of these risk factors quadruples the risk. And if you smoke, have high blood pressure, and have high blood cholesterol, your risk increases eightfold. This certainly makes you think. This is the first in a series of three videos focusing on simple changes you can make to lower your cholesterol, your blood pressure, and help you quit smoking. The foods we eat play a major role in keeping our cholesterol levels low. The best part is that you don't need to put tons of restrictions on your diet in order to see positive changes. Making a few tiny improvements can yield significant reductions in LDL cholesterol, or the bad cholesterol. According to a study on the effects of food on your cholesterol, an easy first step to lowering your cholesterol may simply be having a bowl of oatmeal for breakfast. Barley, oatmeal, and brown rice have lots of soluble fiber, which has been proven to bind to cholesterol molecules in the small intestine, preventing them from entering the bloodstream. Try switching out your regular pasta for the whole grain version, or use brown rice instead of white rice. And to give your breakfast an added cholesterol-busting kick, top your morning oatmeal with high-fiber fruit, like bananas or berries, and maybe a bit of honey for taste. One bowl of oats per day may result in a 10% reduction in your cholesterol levels in just 4 weeks. The next step is to add foods such as nuts, avocados, fish, and tomatoes to your diet, as they work like soluble fiber. Only about 20% of the cholesterol in your bloodstream comes from the food you eat. The liver makes the other 80% out of saturated fats and sugar. Saturated fats are usually solid at room temperature and consist of foods such as butter, cheese, the fat in meat, and coconut oil. French fries also contain high amounts of saturated fats from the oil they're cooked in. If you love the crunch of fried food, use an air fryer for a lower-fat fried taste. Or bake potato wedges at a high temperature until they're golden brown. Cookies, cakes, and pastries are made with large quantities of butter and sugar, making these high in cholesterol too. You might want to try stevia instead of sugar. Stevia is about 100 to 300 times sweeter than table sugar, but it has zero calories, carbohydrates, or artificial ingredients. A recent study showed that the consumption of stevia significantly decreased the levels of LDL cholesterol, but increased the levels of HDL, which is good cholesterol. You may be wondering whether changing your diet will make a difference. Here's the evidence to prove it. An interesting multinational study compared the diets of countries with low and high heart attack rates and studied Japanese people who had migrated to Hawaii. These people had adopted Western dietary habits, so their diet contained more fat than the typical Japanese diet, but not as much as the typical American diet. The study shows that the Japanese people in Hawaii had higher rates of heart attacks than those in Japan. And interestingly, the Japanese people who migrated to San Francisco went even further in adopting American dietary habits and had, therefore, rates of coronary heart disease similar to Americans. I hope this video has convinced you that it is the amount and the quality of the food you eat that determines your cholesterol levels, and not solely your genetics. Thank you for watching this video. Please watch my next video if you'd like to learn about how you can lower your blood pressure.